Welcome everyone to One Warrior Wrestling Live. Our debut here in Los Angeles, California is going to start off with some tag team action as we see the debuting Blaze Clan take on the tag team champions of El Rey Dallaire and Gavin Daniels. The Blaze Clan, for the uninitiated, is Teddy Savepoint and Tyler Hummel coming together after a connection formed on something I'm told is called Bed Wars, which I am far too old to understand. Blaze Clan, though, starting off with a big opportunity, as if they could pick up a win over the doubles champions here tonight, that would definitely go a long way in establishing them here in One Warrior Wrestling, especially ahead of next week. If Looks Could Kill versus Gavin Daniels and El Rey Dallaire for the doubles championships, once again, we'll be in Los Angeles, California next week. So Blaze Clan definitely have a big opportunity right here tonight. I think that these two could go a long way. Both men have extensive wrestling experience. Tyler Hummel, even a former tag team champion with his brother Scott, various different promotions. This is the first time that the 1WW faithful around have seen the Blaze Clan. Out first is son of Kazuya Mitsushi himself, El Rey Dallaire, one half of the doubles champions. Next week, himself and Gavin Daniels will make their first defense of the championship. They are undefeated in tag team competition. So definitely going to be a must-see matchup next week. But here in the One Warrior Wrestling debut of the Los Angeles Coliseum, you see fan favorite El Rey Dallaire make his way down the aisle. Definitely has his supporters here tonight. El Rey, one to keep your eye on for absolute certain. I think even beyond the scope of the tag team that he has with Gavin Daniels, this unlikely pairing that we've seen, El Rey Dallaire could stand to be a major player in 1WW for a long time coming. Right now, he's got to be focused on Tyler Hummel and Teddy Savepoint. Two men who he has never shared a ring with before, but definitely two men he cannot afford to underestimate. Dallaire really carries a lot of honor and dignity with that doubles championship. Absolutely holds it in high esteem, high prestige. Are you deaf? Can you hear me? 'Cause I'm sick of it all. Are we sticking in my skin? Are we pushing my back to the wall? And a man who definitely holds a lot in high prestige, but seemingly not his unit with El Rey Dallaire, is Gavin Daniels. Gavin has been incredibly critical of El Rey Dallaire since the unit formed, though they have been incredibly successful. The Punk Rock Paradox has had no shortage of criticism for his supposed partner in this ordeal. You can even see El Rey Dallaire there seemingly shrugging at Gavin Daniels, wondering at what point will they start to enter like a tag team? At what point will they start to do anything like a tag team? You know, oftentimes we hear of tag teams rooming together, riding show to show together, but reports have circulated that Gavin Daniels, as soon as the bell rings, the match is over. He doesn't talk to El Rey at all. No love lost. See Gavin Daniels having a little conversation with cameraman number 14 there. Very, very talkative is the Punk Rock Paradox. But
His gift of gab has led him to one half of the Tubbles Championships here in One Warrior Wrestling USA. So let's see if Gavin Daniels and Ray Dallaire can continue their winning ways. Referee James Jackson rings the bell, and we are getting started here. Big power slam there by El Rey Dallaire to start. One fall to a finish is the name of the game here in this tag team contest. Big German on the neck of Gavin Daniels. Takes him down hard. Blaze Clan would love to get a win here, because even if El Rey and Gavin lose the doubles championships next week, that would no doubt put Blaze Clan right in line for a shot if they can beat the then doubles champions Gavin and El Rey. Look at that fantastic setup into a swinging fallaway drop from Tyler Hummel. It has been all Blaze Clan in the opening portion of this match. Though El Rey fires through with that big knee strike to the face. Big Beal toss from Tyler Hummel. You did not expect that kind of power from a guy his size. Now Tyler focuses in on El Rey Dallaire and a big face buster. Tyler Hummel, the only man left standing after that. Teddy, save point, flip to nowhere in particular, and Gavin exits the ring, and Teddy tries to come after him, but Gavin moves out of the way. James Jackson, the incumbent official here in One Warrior Wrestling USA, big Northern Lights on the bat by Gavin Daniels, and a corkscrew shooter to the back of El Rey Dallaire. Good God. That was a hellacious landing. Gavin in there just a little too late. Seemed like he was not too concerned with breaking it up. Knee lift. Poisoned Frankensteiner from Hummel. Goes up to the top. Gavin in a bad spot. Big attack from save point as El Rey gets the counter. Has him hooked. Could do anything from this position. Opts for a Kazi. A kill shot. Does El Rey Dallaire. Could Teddy save point be in for the break? Unneeded as Tyler gets the kick out. And Gavin is disarmed by Teddy save point. Big attack there by El Rey Dallaire. Goes in for the cover. Only gets two as Gavin goes a swinging. Looking to maybe play for the Dodgers with shots like that. As El Rey takes down Tyler Hummel. Gavin and Teddy have spent a considerable portion on the outside here. Keep your eyes on Teddy. Airplane spin into a TKO and a huge chair shot to the face of Tyler Hummel. That is rough, unprotected, right to the head, swinging for the fences, or more like the barrier with that shot, but Gavin manages to absorb and is firing on. Huge toss to the other portion of the arena. Keep your eyes on Tyler Hummel. Small package applied. Gavin looked like he was ready to go in for the break, but El Rey got the kick out. Nice jumping leg drop there by Tyler Hummel. Springboard sling blade from Hummel as well to El Rey Dallaire. We've been seeing some incredible athleticism by Hummel. Big bicycle knee into the poisoned Rana once again. We see it connect. Singapore Kane grabbed by Gavin, disarmed by save point. El Rey's a sitting duck. Maya Rana to El Rey, and Teddy has Gavin up. Big drop. And a GTS into a go to sleep from Tyler Hummel off the German, and the Blaze Clan become the first team to defeat Gavin Daniels and El Rey Dallaire. That is a hell of a debut for this new upstart tag team. Could that spell doom and gloom for El Rey Dallaire and Gavin Daniels' doubles championship reign? We'll find out as we get into the next match. To our next contest, We have got the number one contenders to the doubles championships. It looks good, Kill, represented by Max Sanchez. He's going to be taking on Chance Riser of the reality. You know, they absolutely loved just now seeing Gavin Daniels and El Rey Del Air lose in their opening contest against the Blaze Clan. If looks could kill next week, they will have the opportunity to win the doubles championships after surviving the eight-man gauntlet just last week. Max Sanchez and Handsome Hernandez have been on a hell of a roll since 1WWUSA began. But last week in that eight-man gauntlet, one thing that stuck out in particular was the apparent bad blood between Chance Riser and Max Sanchez. Those two did battle on the outside for nearly 15 minutes of the 25-minute match runtime, on and off. So definitely something that needs to be settled, it is safe to say. But making their way out next is, of course, the reality. And they are being led to the ring by the holder of their NDAs, Chris Danger. They have won tag team championships in many portions of the world, but they have yet to do so here in One Warrior Wrestling USA. They look to do it possibly here soon, but first they've got to settle whatever this bad blood the Chance Riser and Max Sanchez have with one another. Clearly two teams destined for greatness, determined to be the best. Just a matter of who can outlast what. The fans very adamantly against Chris Danger. Max Sanchez, you see, exiting the ring, giving the reality the floor, knowing that even with Chris Danger lurking in the background, see Max there giving some harassment to Chris Danger in the back, as is pretty much every ticket holder here in Los Angeles, California. Here in the LA Coliseum, a lot of people have a lot to say about the reality and the NDA. Let's get into this one. It'll be interesting to see if any of the three men on the outside between the two corners get involved, as Sanchez, the technically superior wrestler, you'd have to give him the credit. Also, the hometown advantage for Max Sanchez from nearby San Diego, California. Sanchez going up to the top rope as Riser delivers a shot, but a diving Rana from Sanchez off the top is incredible. Max Sanchez, definitely one who has a bright future here in One Warrior Wrestling. We've seen him in some incredibly classic matches already, but his tag team acumen with Handsome Hernandez is second to none as Riser falls there, unable to break the defenses of Max Sanchez. Huge toss in the corner by Sanchez to Riser, and now Riser playing defensively gets that back elbow up. Not something you want to be in a position to do, is play defense against Max Sanchez, the Latin American executioner. Hard to counter, hard to scout against, as he just begins pulling on the neck of Chance Riser. But Chance does manage to find a quick escape, and now staying on top of Sanchez with a nice neck breaker there from the Millennial. Now grabbing him, running Fisherman's Buster with a high hook. Fantastic bridge as well. Gets the two, but not quite three. That could have been a finish at any other point in the matchup, but Riser not going to put away Sanchez that early. Sanchez spins Riser around as they get into it. Poison Rana from Max Sanchez, and his hometown crowd very much behind the Latin American executioner as he sends him in. Big rolling clothesline, roll through into a blockbuster. Max Sanchez is going incredible right now. He is firing on all cylinders. Looks like he went for the execution, but couldn't quite get it done. And now Reiser begins to reestablish his control on the matchup, but Sanchez with a shot from the ground into the stomach. Definitely not a bad way to get into it. And now big back suplex keeps the waist lock. It was a fantastic German there. Could be looking for the Cologne family special. The tripleta, that brain buster to follow through. Fantastically done. But Reiser kick right in the top of the head. Grabs him in a German of his own. This one has quickly turned into a suplex showdown as Reiser grabs Max Sanchez, has him hooked, cradle, DDT! Rising tide raises all ships and may lead to the raised hand of Chance Reiser, but Sanchez gets the kick out at two. Fantastic resilience by the Latin American executioner. Lift up into that gut buster, targeting the midsection of Reiser is very smart. As Sanchez looks to head to the top, we have thankfully not seen any interference play part from either side thus far. Sanchez up to the top, big crossbody, but a miss. Looks like he timed that one incorrectly, but staying on the offense, throws him back in the corner. And just slams Reiser into the corner. A second slam right into the corner there by Max Sanchez, and a huge chop. He is just taking Reiser to task here. Has him up with a big snake eyes as well, and Reiser staggers out of the corner. So Max Sanchez wants to keep him in a bad spot, but can't quite bring himself to do it. Shot to the stomach. Sanchez staying on top of Chance Reiser again, going back for this gut buster. He's been all over the midsection, goes for the cover. Could have him there, but only gets two on Chance Reiser. Max Sanchez, you know if he can lock in the execution, then it will be all over, you'd have to presume. Now in the opposite portion of the ring, Chance Reiser looks like he may have a little cut around the eye, sent across the ring by Max Sanchez, runs in for the lariat. Saw him do this before, can he do it a second time? Runs through for the blockbuster, fantastic elevation by Max Sanchez. Now Sanchez looking possibly to take the leg. He has it. He spins him over. Could be all over the execution. Locked in that single leg crab, and he is cinched down deeply on it. And Chance Reiser forced to submit to the execution. Just a little more momentum gained from If Looks Could Kill. On the back of a loss from El Rey Delair and Gavin Daniels. Not good. Max Sanchez continues his undefeated streak. Now 4-0 here in 1WW. A man to keep your eye on for sure as we move into the next matchup. And as we get into our next contest, we have got the seemingly unkillable Adam Jobs taking on Michael Young, who is returning. It was a few weeks ago that he lost to Dylan Hyatt in that Texas Deathmatch for the One Warrior Wrestling Heavyweight Championship. Adam Jobs has clearly taken some critique of his muscle mass to heart, as he's put on at least, what's that, 80, 90 pounds of pure muscle in a week? That's incredible. Adam Jobs making his way down the aisle. Last week, losing to Wade Urena. The end of that matchup saw Adam get twisted and turned around in a very painful way. But Adam survived. He only got a major minor concussion out of the ordeal. But now he faces Michael Young, fresh off of some irritation at the hands of Colin Prince, who we saw debut last week in a shock loss to Kieran Culsworth. So Mikey's definitely going to have some frustration to work out, you'd have to imagine here. Poor Adam Jobs will be on the receiving end of it, fortunately for him. Michael Young, of course, man inspired by many things, but most of those find their way back to Japanese wrestling in the 90s. The King's Road style of professional wrestling has inspired Michael Young so thoroughly. Now he makes his way down the aisle, a man who two times now has failed to capture the One Warrior Wrestling Heavyweight Championship from Dylan Hyatt. Showed a bit of gratitude, a bit of respect to Hyatt after their Texas Death Match. Hyatt attempted to share the same. Now Mikey is focusing on something more important than a championship. It is a matter of respect. Teacher versus student. Colin Prince has challenged Michael's teaching principles. See if he can put those into action here against Adam Jobs. Adam starting off with a couple of shots against Michael Young, staggering the big Aussie assassin. Mikey, though, fires right back in with a brain buster to Adam Jobs. That is a hell of a way to start a matchup, and very, very in character from Michael Young. Mikey not done that quickly, though. Pile driver to Jobs as well. Good God, Adam Jobs' neck better be made of steel. So now Mikey running power slam to Adam Jobs. Mikey up to the top rope. We don't often see Young leave his feet. Where will Michael go? Diving dropkick, but nobody home. That may be why we don't see him attempt it often. Not exactly a marksman when it comes to off the top rope. Huge slam out of the corner, though, from Young. And Michael Young now. Springboard poison Rana continues to spiking Adam Jobs' head into the mat. Good Lord, Mikey. What in the world has gotten into him? Breaking necks and cashing checks, it would seem. But Adam Jobs keeps coming back for more. And now Mikey using his superior size to buck off Adam Jobs multiple times over. Jobs, though, going in for the kicks and the punches. Mikey has not been taken down by Adam Jobs once in this matchup. Michael with a big chop, but Adam fires back in, continuing to go for those leg kicks. Can Mikey finally start to be broken down by Adam Jobs? Jobs has Mikey in the zone. Could be looking to load up the torpedo for the Garfield torpedo from Adam Jobs there by Michael Young. The first time taking him down in the whole match, and Adam is starting to use those incredibly very real muscles to deal some damage to Michael Young. Mikey is just getting now a little bit of beat down by Adam Jobs as Michael Young cannot even seem to get himself under himself. Adam Jobs throwing Mikey back in the ring. This would be a hell of a win for Adam Jobs. Maybe the biggest win of his career if he could pull it off. I mean, I can think of nothing bigger. Adam grabs Mikey, but Mikey just delivers shot after shot into the midsection, and it does not even matter. Big knee lift, and again, the poison Rana. That's five times that Adam has been spiked on his head. Mikey went for the senton, but once again, the ropes have not been playing to his strengths in this one. Mikey grabbed by Adam Jobs, but fights him off. Shots to the midsection there by Michael Young. Runs in and nails him with the torpedo. Odie from Adam Jobs and gets a two. Could not quite get it done there. Michael Young with an overhead. Bimmy to Jimmy to Adam Jobs, excuse me, now picks him up, has him in sight. Tiger Driver 92 from Michael Young goes in for the cover. Young gets the kick out at two. Now Mikey has him ready for the kill. Could be looking to dial it up. 585 off with his head. And that has to do it. Michael Young gets the win. And once again, we see Adam Jobs put up a hell of a fight, but it ultimately does not matter when Michael Young dials 585. You're done, son. Get in the next match. As we get into our next contest, for those who are squeamish or those who are not accustomed to especially brutal matchups, I advise you either look away or prepare for the beating of a lifetime as Walter de Ring General takes on Kevin Bulmer. It's going to be brutality, mayhem, and violence versus poise and trained chaos. The Ring General Walter makes his way down the aisle, his 1WW debut. Very familiar to California is Walter. It is probably in America his most famous territory that he occupied. Man, world traveled. Very few can lay claim to have left a trail of destruction and decimation as wide and as long and storied as Walter has. The Ring General has never met a man that he hasn't put into the ground. Looks to do the same here tonight against Kevin Bulmer. The Bulmer will have the wild card in the form of Dirk accompanying him. Walter comes out sans Ringkampf. Man, only motivated by the pain that he can inflict to others. Will he be able to do that to someone as expertly trained as Kevin Bulmer? Kevin Bulmer makes his way down the stairs here in Los Angeles, California, making his One Warrior Wrestling debut as well. So two debutantes here tonight. Kevin Bulmer definitely looking ready to deal some damage. Have to wonder if his more orthodox style of fighting is going to be able to play counter to someone as violent as Walter, who plays by no rules. Stoic. Two men ready to inflict damage. Last chance to look away if you are squeamish. Goes for the rising hand immediately, but Bulmer able to immediately counter. And he puts Walter on the ropes and uses them to his advantage to deliver some striking knees right to the jaw. Kevin Bulmer proving exactly why it matters so much to have incredible control of your opponent, but Walter just kicked to the back of the leg. Goes in for the lariat, and again, Bulmer has the counter with that sliding elbow. Walter has not hit any offense in this matchup other than counters, as Bulmer has had the answer to it. They have already spilled to the outside immediately, and a huge chop, one of many, I'm assuming. This one is already starting off very brutally, going for the butterfly suplex, but Walter countered by the incredible poise and acumen of Kevin Bulmer, a karate champion, multiple times over, applying some brutal neck snap there, and now grabbing the wrist and snapping backwards for that arm breaker. Walter with a counter from the floor. Bulmer back up, goes for the kick, and it is evaded by Walter. German from the Austrian to the American on the outside. Into the barrier, no less, and Walter has him again. Goes for another German, but Bulmer countered it. This one has been counter for counter. It's been no time in the ring. A chop is all it takes for Walter to regain control as Bulmer back up to his feet. It has gotten back in the ring, which is where it will finish. Bulmer, look at that strength, lifting up the 300-pounder just for the snake eyes. Walter in for the shotgun dropkick. This one has already been brutal, and the leg drop comes crashing down. Must have hurt inside. Walter grabbing Bulmer, but Bulmer grabs the leg and drills him. Bulmer, of course, wears no shoes, no hand guards. Walter, no hand guards, no knee pads. Both men like to have their entire bodies or as much as they are willing to sacrifice open and available to deal damage. That headbutt led to a lariat attempt, which is countered by Bulmer, but Valter does not hesitate, and that's one power bomb to Bulmer. That was vicious. He's looking for a couple more. That's two. Three. And four. We heard that Bulmer had been training to counter the power bomb, but clearly the offensive flurry of Valter may have made that training a little bit of a non-factor, as Valter has now already delivered four power bombs to Kevin Bulmer. Bulmer attacks the exposed knee of Valter. That's why doing something like that is so dangerous. Huge forearm shiver and a rising hand chop, and Valter once again gains control over Kevin Bulmer. Drops him on the top rope, and Bulmer is in a bad position in the corner as Valter is just kicking him, but Bulmer gets back to his feet. High kick is once again blocked by Valter. Bulmer has not been able to connect with hardly any kicks. Huge twisting Uranagi slam from Valter. Does not quite get the three. Valter definitely tried to put it away there, but could not quite execute on what he needed to. Goes for another powerbomb, but Bulmer countered it. High kick, and Valter's back on the ropes. And Bulmer targeting the arm after countering the powerbomb. Not a bad strategy at all. But Bulmer once again blocked by Valter. Up and over, and they are headed back to the outside. Valter, dangerous man on the outside so much. Devastation can be done. Oh, good Lord, look at this. Just a release tiger bomb there by Valter. Bulmer, though, with a huge kick. That is the first time we've seen those legs successfully connect with the head of Valter from Bulmer, and Bulmer wants him back in. Valter could be out cold after that kick. He's getting back to his feet. You see Dirk observing very intently. Oh, good Lord. Ah, the clubbing shot to the chest of Bulmer. That could have collapsed a chest cavity, but Bulmer manages to survive. That was hellacious. And now just firing in the knees. Nakamura-esque with the violent shots of the left knee to the eardrum, right to the temple. And now Valter locks in the dragon sleeper. He's got it in deep. Will Bulmer be forced to submit? Will James Jackson have to call the match after this dragon sleeper? Can Bulmer prevail? Can he escape? Valter lets him up. Bulmer back to his feet. High kick connects. That could be all he needs as he throws Valter into the corner. And now just lacing him with shots and a huge spinning back kick to the face. But Valter gets right back up. Goes for the rising hand chop, but couldn't connect. Bulmer with a big shot to the back, utilizing both his wrestling acumen and his karate acumen there, and then another kick and a huge forearm shiver right to the jaw of Valter. Kevin Bulmer is just trying with everything he can, double legs him, and now just pie facing him. Right in the face is Kevin Bulmer. Now spinning back kick to Valter. Goes in for the cover, could have him done, and he does. Kevin Bulmer gets the win over Valter. He withstood a lot of offensive maneuvers from Valter, even four power bombs, but managed to counter any more, and Valter never got back into it as we get into the next match. And as we get into our next contest, we have got Aaron Wesley, the big double A, making his way down the aisle, and he is taking on Johnny McGuinness. Aaron Wesley, a man who has been gaining notoriety all across the American independent wrestling scene for being a very tough man. Videos went viral, gaining hundreds of thousands of views of seeing this man take damage that most men would be down for the count, getting up and asking for another. So Aaron Wesley definitely could fare well here in the hard-hitting hellscape that is One Warrior Wrestling USA. But he's taking on a man who was so very close to winning the Dragon Warrior Championship just a few weeks ago. The godsend, Johnny Beginnis, makes his way down the aisle. It was 2 weeks ago, 7-4, the score that kept Johnny Beginnis from winning the Dragon Warrior Championship. CC Chambers will see in action later tonight, the man who beat him. Johnny Beginnis, in his return match after that loss, definitely looking to get some retribution for that embarrassment. Johnny Beginnis has been incredibly impressive here in One WWUSA. Man with a bright future. Often a bit of a bold statement to claim that someone could very easily be a world champion in the future, but Johnny Beginnis has all the tools. It just seems that he can't use them all together at this time, but the Rough Diamond can very much be reformed to be a top-tier world-traveled athlete. A godsend, as they call him. This one is going to be a match of bigger men doing battle. You know that CC Chambers, Ricky Starks going to be watching this match closely. One of them will walk away with the Dragon Warrior Championship in our main event tonight. Also, of course, last week with the announcement of the Cazador Championship honoring the late, great Cazador Dragon. We already know the participants of the one-night tournament that will take place on the night of Dead Man's Hand in Sin City, nearby here, Los Angeles, California. But one of these men could look to become a contender for that championship as well. Let's ring the bell as James Jackson does. Johnny Beginnis immediately grabbing Aaron Wesley, and that is a display of power right there. And a guy the size of Wesley, and then a big striking kick to the back. Johnny Beginnis just starting in with the shots to the face. A smack as well. Johnny Beginnis mounting him a second time and just delivering the shots to the face. Clearly still frustrated at the fact that it is not him here tonight facing Ricky Starks, defending what he believes should be his Dragon Warrior Championship. Biggest boy sent on two times in a row by Aaron Wesley. Johnny Beginnis back up and just takes his head off with that running shoulder tackle. And look at that, another display of power. Shoot. Throwing Aaron Wesley all the way across the ring and pushing him back. And a shoulder tackle of his own by Aaron Wesley. This has been an incredible amount of power shown by both men in the early portion. Wesley goes for a headbutt, but Beginnis moves out of the way. That could have spelled early doom and gloom for Beginnis. Huge forearm shiver. And now a release suplex from Aaron Wesley. These two have just been doing variations on the same maneuvers. Hits the headbutt on the second attempt. Aaron Wesley and Johnny Beginnis have been trying to see who exactly is the stronger of the two. Big meaty men slapping meat as Beginnis gets out of the corner, hits a jujikatoki there, went for a snap jab, but had to go with the knee instead. Johnny Beginnis now up on the shoulders of Aaron Wesley. It's a dangerous position to be in as he is dropped on the top rope, snake eyes style. And now look for some nonchalant power by Aaron Wesley. Could hold him up there for as long as he wanted, but opts for a spin and drop from over 7 feet down when his arms are fully extended like that. Big running clothesline is actually caught and clubbers him with a shot to the back of the head. Stomp to the arm of Aaron Wesley is a smart game there by Johnny Beginnis, a master tactician for as much as he is a fantastic professional wrestler and a beacon of strength. Went for that big lariat, did Aaron Wesley, but nobody home. Takes the arm and is just stomping away on it. Wesley, though, shoots back to his feet and hits a big dragon screw on Beginnis. Still, it feels like they're in the opening measures, despite hitting some major bombs in this matchup. Aaron Wesley going back to the release suplex, which served him and Beginnis both well. And now Wesley takes stance, could be looking to mow through Beginnis. And he does with that spear, taking him and chopping him in half. That was vicious by Aaron Wesley. Wesley throws Beginnis into the corner, has ill intentions in mind from that corner, just clubbing him in the side of the head with those elbows. That is not a fun place to be. Johnny Beginnis motionless on the ground as now Aaron Wesley stays on him. Big stomp to the arm. And now he has him stomped to the back and locking him in. Gonna break the back, make him humble. Locked in deep, that camel clutch, but Wesley was countered by Beginnis. Beginnis has Wesley up now, and he hits a... Oh my God! Look at this! Are you kidding me? That is incredible strength by Johnny Beginnis. Even goes one-handed for a second for that delayed vertical suplex. Running penalty kick to the back. This has been the most intriguing display of power matching I've seen in a long time as Wesley once again gets full mounted by Johnny Beginnis. No lack of disrespect from Beginnis. And that overhead belly to belly. My God. Beginnis looks like he could throw Wesley all the way to the cheap seats. But a smack in the face by Wesley. Went for a one of his own. But Beginnis not going to stand for that. Johnny Beginnis again with an overhead belly to belly. Good God. And then follows through with that PK once again. And now just... staying on top of Aaron Wesley is Johnny Beginnis. This is the move, the smart strategy to make. Beginnis uses the ropes to get a little bit more distance out of that back suplex and again goes back to the lower back with that penalty kick. Johnny Beginnis is targeting the midsection. That's very smart as he went for the interceptor. Wesley countered it with a DDT and it looks like Wesley inadvertently gave a cut to the forehead of Beginnis up and down. Ground zero from Aaron Wesley. And that will not spell the end of it. Johnny Beginnis kicks out of the ground zero by Aaron Wesley, but he's not done. Up on the shoulders a second time, ground zero from Big Double A. Can Beginnis power out a second time? Yes, he will. Johnny Beginnis fighting with everything he's got. A man determined to prove that he deserves to remain in the conversation of champions. Kicking out of back-to-back ground zeros. That is incredibly impressive. Now targeting the leg of Aaron Wesley. Oh my goodness, look at that for the Bimmy to Jimmy. Nearly throws him out of the ring. My God. Johnny Beginnis now with a huge power bomb. And a Beginnis knee strike to Wesley. Goes in for the cover and does not quite get the three. This has been hellacious. This could very well be a heavyweight championship match, and I don't think anyone would complain. These two definitely have that in their immediate future. We see the slugfest into the interceptor. Nearly split him in half and does not get the three. Good God. This crowd biting on every single big bomb thrown by both men. Huge toss by Beginnis. Wesley back to his feet and takes him down, running Lariat STO and the biggest boy senton from Aaron Wesley. Picks him up once again. Aaron Wesley throws Beginnis into the corner. And again with these sledges, just trying to open up that cut on the face of Johnny Beginnis. You see the blood dripping into the eyes from the forehead. Absolutely brutal. And then a kick in the head by Beginnis as well goes back into the full mount. This is just brutal at this point and smacks him right in the face. It seems like there's some genuine bad blood here between Aaron Wesley and Johnny Beginnis. As Liger Bomb by Beginnis plants Aaron Wesley. At this point, what do you have to do to put one of these guys away? Beginnis just stalking him, wondering the same thing that we all are. Goes back to the back with that PK. And Wesley back up and takes down by a DDT from Beginnis. The same counter that Wesley used to counter the interceptor and give that cut to Johnny Beginnis. Huge knee shot right to the stomach. Wesley with these backbreakers to Beginnis and just tossing him nearly out of the ring. Takes point. If he can split him in half with this spear, this could spell the end for Beginnis. Right through the middle with that spear. That is brutal from Aaron Wesley. 350 pounds coming at you like a freight train. Goes in for the cover and gets the win. That was a particularly hard-hitting slugfest. Courtesy of Aaron Wesley and Johnny Beginnis. But Wesley comes out victorious as we move into the next matchup. As we get into our next contest, we have got some junior heavyweight action for you as Aaron Ace Marshall makes his 1WW debut, taking on Kanala Parata. Aaron Ace Marshall has drawn some criticism by Kevin Brutus following the way he slacked off his former tag team partner Blaze Henderson during his retirement announcement. Aaron Ace Marshall saying he owed no respect to Blaze Henderson for stealing a year of his career. Whether that is true or false is up to interpretation, but Aaron Wesley out to prove that he believes he is the best thing going that nobody knows about. Aaron Ace Marshall, world-class competitor, a second-generation wrestler, the son of 1WW Women's Division legend Destiny Jade. And how fitting that her son has his emergence possibly as one of America's next top wrestlers as she winds her own career down on her own terms over across the pond in FNF. But Kanala Parata, the man who stands across from Aaron Ace Marshall. Kanala Parata, a couple of weeks ago, was victorious in an incredible matchup against Yamashita. We saw a real brutal side done in by Kanala Parata, the swashbuckling scoundrel. This man is absolutely unhinged and incensed. We have learned that Kanala Parata will meet with Mark Adams in 2 weeks' time in Sin City for Dead Man's Hand. What is being called a pirate brawl. It'll be interesting to see what that entails. We know there's a lot of bad blood between these two men. Were the things said and done. Too many feel they were held down by tag teams for large portions of their career, now making names for themselves in very brash ways. Kanala Parata, he has an energy to him, an emblematic desire to succeed, almost as if it's something that ate away at him for years and years before finally being allowed do as he pleases. So this one's going to be interesting. Definitely a stylistic juxtaposition to our last contest. Aaron Ace Marshall and Kanala Parata do battle as Kanala starts in with the lefts on Aaron Marshall. Drops the knee on the arm. Both of these men will have dates with Destiny in Sin City. Kanala will be face-to-face with Mark Adams. Aaron Ace Marshall face-to-face with Kevin Brutus. Two men who are going to be much, much larger than them. Look at Kanala with the diving headbutt. Seemed to come up a little short, and Aaron Marshall still on the back foot in this opening portion. Kanala just face-raking Aaron Marshall with the elbow. Choking him in the corner as well. It's all legal here in 1WW. Though Kanala does give him the break, shows his hands. Aaron Marshall has just not been able to get out of this opening portion. Marshall back in. Big boot is countered. Kanala managed to stay in it. Big cord buster. We know next week Aaron Ace Marshall will be facing Speedball Mike Bailey. So it's definitely going to be another junior heavyweight showcase for Aaron Marshall. But he's got to start showcasing some stuff here because Canala Parada is taking him to school right now. A kick out at one by Marshall, but Marshall has not really done much of nothing in this match. Big chop to Parada. Good look to change that. Moonsault DDT by Aaron Marshall. That was incredible. Fantastic control of the ropes by Aaron Marshall. Now grabbing Canala. Aaron has him. And oh my goodness, the Destiny Breaker by Aaron Marshall out of nowhere. A shade to his mother, Destiny Jade. Snapdragon goes in for the cover. Only gets two. Tornado kick to the back of Aaron Marshall there by Canala Parada. Has him now for that huge slam down on Marshall's back and a kick out at two. Aaron Marshall not going to be done in that easily. Now grabbing the leg of Canala Parada and nailing him with that dragon screw. Canala once again dropped down as Aaron takes him down there with that knee drop to the arm. Aaron has not done nearly as much in this match as Canala has, but it still may not matter. Big frog splash from Aaron Marshall. And now Aaron Ace staying in control. You see that veteran poise that he has, trained by Joseph David in the Hollywood Wrestling Academy, not too far from here. And now has him with that huge crossroads. The spin doctor from Aaron Marshall gets two. Know that Aaron Marshall wants more than anything to get a win here, to get some momentum, and to maybe be able to silence what the things that Kevin Brutus said about him. Up on the middle rope, keep your eyes on Marshall. Huge Hail Mary with that running Frankensteiner off the top from Aaron Ace. And now a shot to the face by Canala, and they are slugging it out. Canala shoots Aaron over the ropes. Aaron lands on the apron, though, fires back in. Aaron with a springboard went for something big, but Canala evaded like the best of them. Huge thrust kick caught, but does not catch the second. And Canala now looking for another tornado kick to the back of Aaron Marshall. And now has him hooked once again for that huge full Nelson slam. Aaron Marshall's got to be done after that, you think, and he's not. Canala thought he had him, but definitely getting frustrated after that second slam, unable to get the win. Aaron in, Rolling Thunder into the face breaker, caught him out of nowhere. Aaron had to pull a trick out of his bag, but he caught Canala, does not get the win. Aaron Marshall and Canala, they are building the future here. As Aaron tries to stay on top of Canala, looking to maybe go for another frog splash. We saw him hit it earlier. No, calling Canala to attention to his feet. What in the world is this? A huge jumping crossbody off the top, turned backwards for extra elevation. Does not get the three. That was an incredible leap of faith by Aaron Marshall. That did not ultimately get him the win. Aaron has him on the ropes now. What does he have in mind here? Stun gun, huge jumping neck breaker as well by Marshall. Picks him up, goes to spin him around. Could have been looking for another crossroads. Couldn't quite get it. Snapdragon on the neck. These guys are firing on all cylinders. Caribbean kick from Canala Parada. Count to 100. Not quite. Aaron kicks out at two from the Caribbean kick. These guys giving no quarter, asking of none from the other. Kick and punch combo from Canala as he just laces Aaron Marshall here. Aaron stays standing until he doesn't. Canala with that low drop kick takes him down. Canala targeting the arm of Aaron Marshall. Kick in the back may be the bad move. Aaron grabbing him. Has him, he did the deal, the Falcon Arrow from Aaron Ace Marshall. Picks him back up, spins him around, does not manage to get him hooked, jumps in for the kick, but nobody home. Aaron Marshall grabs him. Boom! Twisting brain buster from Aaron Ace. These guys are delivering a masterclass here. Neither man wants to say die. As a destiny breaker from Aaron Marshall. With a nod to his mother, could he get the win? He does. Aaron Marshall picks up a fantastically impressive win over Kanala Parata. Yeah, I told you, I'm on the mission, I'm switching. Aaron Ace definitely had to pull out a lot of tricks from a lot of places, but gets the win with the Destiny Breaker. Moving to the next matchup. As we get into our next contest, we have got James Darnell representing the Bloodline taking on Yamashita. Last week, James Darnell was incredibly impressive in his debut against Ricky Starks, an all-time great match. Here in 1WW now, James Darnell looks to take on another man who's been responsible for a lot of great matches here in 1WW, Yamashita. Will Darnell get Yama shit on, or will it be time for some closure? Definitely be decided here tonight, but he is being accompanied by the leader of the Bloodline, John Blood. Full on North Carolina invasion of One Warrior Wrestling USA here in Los Angeles, California, on the opposite side of the country from our normal home of Washington, D.C., the nation's capital. But One Warrior Wrestling, no matter where we are, always has a raucous crowd ready to support some fantastic professional wrestling. Because after all, at the end of the day, One Warrior Wrestling USA is for the love of the sport, for the love of the game, for the love of wrestling. We've seen some incredible matches here tonight already. I have a feeling that this one is going to be no exception to that trend that we have witnessed. James Darnell with that devastating lariat that he calls closure put away many a man and even a few women in his day. While he was unsuccessful in his debut last week, this could certainly be a fantastic way to really prove how devastating that lariat can be. Yamashita, though, fresh off a win against Kevin Brutus, withstood a lot of devastating offense from Kevin Brutus last week. Will he suffer any ill effects from that? Time will tell. You know, Yamashita has been on fire as of late. Even in defeat, Yamashita always seems to put on a masterclass in between the ropes. Would not be surprised to see Yamashita be a heavyweight contender one day. I'm James Darnell, and if I'm Ricky Starks, I'm keeping a close eye on this match as well. There's a lot of matches I'm keeping close eyes on, seeing future prospective challengers. Definitely never a bad thing. Yamashita enters the ring. Man with a definite presence is that of Yamashita. John Blood scoping him out. Could we have a potential member of the Bloodline in Yamashita? That would be an incredible development from this contest. Yamashita really soaking it all in. A man all about the poise, the pomp, the circumstance, the presentation before the match, and then all about the brutality, the devastation, the decimation, and the violence in the ring. Yamashita, great at delegation. So James Darnell, Yamashita, let's get into this one. Yamashita grabs Darnell early and nails him with an air raid bomb right to Darnell off the ropes, immediately in for that jumping frog splash, and Yamashita starting as he means to go on. Yama up to the top rope. What does he have in mind? Big frog splash to Darnell as well. Yamashita starts off hot with that three-hit combo. Looking for it one more time, perhaps. Jumping body splash, but Darnell gets out of the way off the double rope run. Always a risky proposition, giving your opponent so much time to recover. Big backbreaker, and Darnell says, slow it down. And he does just that with that backbreaker stretch. Now just a stomp to the arm of Yamashita. Back in with that stomp kick right in the head by Yamashita. Seeing him go back to this attack once again. The body splash connects, 2 out of 3. And Darnell once again at risk of being Yamashita on as Yamashita nails that spinning spine buster on Darnell. Darnell kicking out at 1 though. Yamashita unable to keep Darnell down as Darnell gets back up. Two very equally sized men, tall boys, doing tall boy things. Fall away slam from James Darnell, and now looking to go big bloke on him with this huge deadlift military press for dropping Yamashita. Be interesting to see if the bandanaed brutalizer John Blood will get involved in this one. As Yamashita yanks Darnell in for that backdrop driver. Good lord. Darnell back to his feet. Yamashita grabs him, but Darnell got there a little quicker. Now the elbow smashes from Yamashita. Darnell ducks it back and fires in, just clattering him. Darnell has him hooked. Big falling powerbomb, and even goes in for the cover. Going tip to tip on that one with that powerbomb, but only a 2. As now Darnell picks up Yamashita, could be looking to try and do some damage to him before prepping for the closure. Drops him right on the top rope there with that snake eyes, and now Darnell, ooh, eats a boot right to the midsection by Yamashita. Yamashita picks Darnell up. A lot of displays of power in this one, and now Yamashita power bombs Darnell to the floor. That is not a fun ride to take down as Yamashita grabs Darnell. Not going to give him any time to rest, but Darnell not wanting any as he grabs Yamashita and just gut wrenches him on the floor. Darnell now grabbing Yamashita and just tossing him back in the ring. The big Carolina Hoss going back after Yamashita, picking him up, and look at this. Emerald Flosion by James Darnell, trailing Yamashita, only gets a 2 count. Does James Darnell back up? Yamashita with the Busaiku knee. Nails James Darnell, and that sets him right up on the shoulders. Yamabama! And that right there is not quite the 3 off the Yamabama. Yamashita thought he had him. Tour of the Islands from Yamashita, hitting all the greatest hits. Does not get the victory for Yamashita. 3 huge bombs, 1 being the Yamabama. Still not enough, but he's looking for another. Darnell bucks him over on the second attempt at the Yamabama. Closure takes his head off. And that could be the finale of the match, but not quite the closure. Unable to put it away. And now, jawjacker from Yamashita to Jizzy Dizzy. Grabs him. Tour of the Islands for a second time. Darnell unconscious. And that's gonna not quite do it. Yama thought he had him, but Yamashita still manages to stay on offense, looking for the Yamabama for another time. Has him up. Yamabama to Darnell once again. And that will spell victory for Yamashita, who has been on something of a roll here lately. Absolutely fantastic performance. James Darnell, nothing to be ashamed of there. Yamashita, just a different breed. Moving to the next contest. And as we get into our next contest, we've got a battle of some rising stars as Bruno Natoli looks to take on Cazador Jr. Bruno Natoli, a young man, a third generation professional wrestler, taking on a fourth generation professional wrestler, so a lot of history between these ropes. Dmitry Vasilev, the counsel of Bruno Natoli, has been training him for exactly this kind of opportunity. Bruno Natoli taking on a son of the late great Cazador Dragon. And now he will try and pick up a big win here tonight. Now, Dmitry has prepped Bruno extensively for this matchup. So will it all pay off when it matters the most? Bruno Natoli could have no better counsel than someone with the mind of Dmitry Vasilev, a man who has seen many greats come and go, has personally wrestled Cazador Dragon as well as Cesar Samuels in the past. So if anyone can prepare Bruno for this matchup, it would be Dmitry Vasilev. But there is preparation and then there is the real deal, and Cazador Jr. is the real deal. Of course, he is making his way down the aisle with his older brother, Cesar Samuels, both the only sons of Cazador Dragon. Cesar Samuels has attained a lot of success in singles competition in America. Cazador Jr. has always found his success in Mexico and Japan. Of course, Cesar Samuels, a 6-year pro, Cazador Jr., an 11-year pro, and neither man is even 25 yet. Doesn't that just make you sick? We get into this contest. This could be a huge night for Bruno Natoli, but Cazador Jr. wants to do everything to prevent that. This man has been wrestling for all of his adult life and most of his adolescence. 23 years old, made his professional debut at the age of 12. Goes up to the top rope with that big body splash. And gets a 2 count out of it. Cazador Jr. up to the top rope once again. Feels so comfortable diving. Goes for another big body splash and connects. Does not go for the immediate cover off of this one. And a springboard moonsault, but nobody home for Cazador Jr. as Bruno just begins delivering kicks to the midsection into the chest. Shooter from Cazador Jr. there. Goes for the kick and nobody home. Cazador Jr. manages to reverse the pressure and fire in the elbows from Bruno Natoli. And Cazador Jr., so experienced in the ring, knows exactly the kind that Bruno Natoli is, a young hotshot who's been told that he's going to be the best. Bruno's not like everyone else, a third generation professional wrestler, grandson of Santana Natoli, a man who Cazador Jr. has actually wrestled in the past. And Bruno grabs Cazador and hits him with a big Samoan drop there. kick to the stomach is evaded as Bruno is placed on the ropes. Cazador has him in line for something. Big arm drag there by Cazador, and a nice twisting drop kick as well. Cazador Jr. has been all over Bruno Natoli in this contest. Has Bruno in line for something big here? What is he looking for? Waits a second before going for that body splash, waiting to see if Bruno would flinch. Goes in for the cover after the fact. Gets a two, but not quite three off of that diving body press. Does Cazador Jr. back up to the top again? We've seen him travel up there so many times here tonight. Have to wonder if eventually the well will run dry for Cazador Jr. And Cazador thinks better of it, but catches Bruno with the thrust kick on the way back and goes back up again. Bruno once again staggers to his feet, and once again Bruno suckered in by Cazador Jr. for that drop kick. Cazador back up to the top rope once again. Spins around, Torneo to Bruno Natoli. Dimitri does not think that this one looks good, but still Bruno kicks out at two from the Torneo, the move that won Cazador Jr. the Mega Japan Heavyweight Championship on two separate occasions in 2017 and 2018. Cazador back up on the top rope, and this time again goes for the body splash, but the well finally dries up for Cazador. Bruno once again picks him up in a big Samoan drop to Cazador Jr. from Bruno Natoli. Bruno with the kick has the neck hangman into a cutter, no doubt learned by Dmitry Vasilev. And now a two count. Only what it gets for Cazador Jr. Laying in the shots is Bruno Natoli. And he is delivering exactly what he needs to in this contest. Cazador sent up and over. Bruno has weathered the storm that was Cazador in the opening measures. Huge hot shot on the top rope, a variation on the stunner. Bruno countered by Cazador on the floor, just laying in those shots on the jawline is Cazador Jr. Cazador throws Bruno into the barrier as now you see Cesar enter frame. And a Yoshitonic on the floor, a code red from Cazador. Cazador with a big chop right to the jaw of Bruno Natoli as well. We know Cazador Jr. will have the opportunity to earn his family's honor by winning the Cazador Championship in the one-night tournament, as now he is just thrown into the apron, by Bruno Natoli. Cesar, to his credit, giving Bruno some space. Cesar has had a lot of praise for the raw talent of Bruno Natoli, but has said that he is too arrogant and needs to be knocked down a peg, which Bruno took a lot of exception to. Bruno even challenging Cesar Samuels to a match, which Cesar, as of this moment, has not accepted, saying that he doesn't feel that it is what is good for Bruno's career, is the verbiage he used, which I'm sure Bruno did not take too kindly to hearing. A young man who's never been told no in his life, but definitely has all the potential in the world. We talk a lot about future possible heavyweight champions, is another Yoshitonic delivered by Cazador Jr. Bruno Natoli pretty high on that list in terms of just raw potential. Cazador perches up top, ready to go down like no other. Oh, good lord. Torneo! But Bruno moves out of the way. The Torneo attempt countered of sorts by Bruno Natoli from Cazador Jr. And now just laying in the shots to the side of the head is Bruno Natoli. And just firing away with the shots to the stomach is Cazador, and another Yoshitonic from Cazador Jr., and he wants Bruno up. Has him in his sights, tries to run in for something big. Cazador hooks him. Vertical suplex swivels the hips. Dragon Killer from Cazador Jr. Could that put him away? No, Bruno kicks out of the Dragon Killer, the move that Cesar used to win a heavyweight championship about this time last year. Cazador breaking out all the stops to try and put away Bruno Natoli, slam in the corner. And now Cazador with a moonsault press to Bruno Natoli, excuse me. And now Cazador has Bruno in the splash zone. Bruno nowhere to go. Cazador spins it around. Tornillo to Bruno Natoli. 2-3. Cazador gets the win. Cazador Jr. proving that having the know-how in the ring is exactly what it takes to get it done. Potential be damned as we move into the next contest. As we get into our next contest, Tony Samuels is going to be taking on a mystery opponent. Tony Samuels lined up to face someone curated specifically by Axel Hyatt. The expletive going to make his way down the aisle, a former heavyweight champion. Tony Samuels has no idea who he will be facing. In some ways that is a blessing, and in most ways that is a curse. Tony, among many other things, is a man who can prepare for any outcome, any situation possible. And that does include facing the unknown. We have heard that the opponent lined up for Tony Samuels here tonight is phenomenal in the ring. Style all of his own. But we will have to be the judge of that first. Cannot be remiss by talking about the expletive Tony Samuels. Of course, we know that at Dead Man's Hand, Tony Samuels will square off with Santos Jarrett in the first round of the Cazador Championship Tournament. Santos and Tony, Yamashita and Cazador. And oh my goodness! Could it be? It's only the phenomenal one, AJ Styles. It is time to get ready to fly. The Prince of Phenomenal making his way down the aisle. This man, one of the all-time greats. I don't know who Tony Samuels was expecting, but I guarantee you it was not AJ Styles. This is going to be a clash in the ring like we have not yet seen. And let's get into this one. AJ grabbing Tony and immediately placing him on the ropes. I don't know who Tony was expecting, but it definitely wasn't AJ Styles. He drops him with a vicious brain buster. Sweeping the leg does Tony Samuels. Tony now just grabbing AJ and dropping him with a variation on an arm breaker there. This absolutely is an incredible acquisition for One Warrior Wrestling USA as a moonsault to the back. A kick in the back as well there from AJ. Now just shots to the face. AJ Styles, one of the greatest of all time. Anywhere he goes, you can well and truly believe that it would be a house that AJ had a hand in building. AJ up to the top. Spiral tap by AJ Styles. That was very quick from AJ. Nearly got the win. A move innovated by AJ, the spiral tap off the ropes. That jumping knee is countered by Tony. Tony now stalking AJ and just nailing their shots to the face. Kick in the stomach by AJ Styles and a moonsault press as well from AJ. Goes in for the cover, hooking both legs deeply, but only gets one off the moonsault press. AJ grabbing Tony. Oh my goodness, already the Styles clash. And Tony busted wide open. But AJ kicks out, or AJ does not get the win as Tony kicks out. That is a nasty gash on the right eye of Tony Samuels. Hope it won't affect his vision at all. As Tony now goes on the offense, AJ has just been lighting Tony up in this one. Tony definitely suffering from lack of time to prepare for AJ. Tony with a big slam out of the corner up to the middle rope he goes. And now diving attack, but AJ not caught with that one. Shot to the stomach from Tony Samuels up on the shoulders. Adjective adjustment from Samuels. Tony Samuels goes in for the cover, the pinfall, but not quite able to get the three. Could it be time to look for nap time? No, Tony opts to go to the corner instead. Yakuza kick to AJ Styles. Two, not quite enough. Goes in and now just the measured kick to the back from Samuels. And he's trying to knock AJ out cold with those shots. And AJ busted open on the right side of his face, and Tony not done. Just these rights and lefts and rights and lefts. Both men busted open, both men bleeding buckets. AJ manages to nail Tony with a shot to the back. What does he have in mind here? Looking for it again. Spiral tap across the way. Good God. Goes in for the cover, but not quite the three off the second spiral tap from AJ Styles. Styles measuring, has him in line. Looking for the second Styles clash. Does AJ Styles two? Not quite as Tony gets the kick out. Kick in the back from AJ Styles, grabs Tony once again and lacing Samuels, but Samuels drops AJ there. AJ now back up and a huge shot to the face. Tony Samuels getting a better position for this German suplex, hooks the ankles on the ground and hooks the hands around the waist, only gets one off that beautiful bridge, however. Now just working the arm for that ringer kick. Tony could be looking to put AJ to sleep here with nap time. No, AJ counters. And Tony managed to block that attempted chop block. Feinted in with the DDT and caught on the back half with the huge DDT as well. Tony back up now, and AJ is too. Went for the kick, nobody home. AJ sent to the floor by Tony Samuels. AJ Styles now in a bad spot as Tony Samuels just stomps him repeatedly. Tony Samuels staying on top of AJ Styles. And Tony with that thrust kick on the floor, he is just absolutely laying it in. And AJ giving it as good as he gets up on the shoulders. Oh, and look at this, the stolen maneuver, the slamules on the outside by AJ Styles. That is dastardly by the Prince of Phenomenal. And a classic AJ Styles combination on the floor by AJ to Tony. AJ grabbed and caught. Another DDT by Tony Samuels. Tony with the stomp, drop kick evaded by AJ. Huge Gamangiri from AJ Styles. AJ grabbing Tony. They got to get back in the ring if they want this one to come to a conclusion. Though the fans certainly wouldn't complain. If these guys went all night long, I'm sure, two fan favorites. AJ on his first night on the job, already a fan favorite. Tony Samuels, years of respect earned. Slam on the barrier right in front of the TNT faithful. Huge shot to the jaw from AJ Styles to Tony Samuels. Punches in the face and a Pele City from AJ Styles. Nobody does a better Pele kick than AJ. That is a 100% veritable fact. Toss right into the barrier, donking him on the head. AJ Styles thrown hither as Tony gets back in the ring and taunts the Prince of Phenomenal. They've got to both be in the ring simultaneously for this one to end. AJ seems like he wants to head back that direction. Laying down the gauntlet for Samuels to pick up. Look at all the blood on the face of Tony Samuels. This is getting hard to watch. Tony grabbed by AJ. Trails him with another Styles clash. 2-3. AJ Styles gets the win. AJ Styles picking up the win over Tony Samuels in his debut. Move into the next matchup. They say you can do it, they ain't made for it. What? What they missing is the path they didn't pay for. That's why I get them props, I keep them low.
Give me what I want.
And as we get into our next contest, we have got Davey B taking on Kel Liudre.
Give me what I want.
Davey B, a man born with a cruel deformity dealt him by the hand of life. But he does not allow that to dissuade him from being a professional wrestler, as was his dream. See him talking to his imaginary friend, Rick. As he walks down the aisle, Davey B, a young man.
And you're gonna give me what I want.
Give me what I want.
You know, say what you want about Davey B. His physical appearance does not deter him from chasing his dreams. something tells me that these dreams may be short-lived as Kelly Oudre makes his way down the aisle. Man known as Killer Kel, banned for life from the sport of kickboxing following unsportsmanlike conduct. Now found his home in the world of professional wrestling, has beaten his way into a world title match, which he will have against Dylan Hyde in 2 weeks' time at Dead Man's Hand. Let's get into this one. Davey B going toe-to-toe with Killer Kel. This is definitely Davey B's biggest match, but Killer Kel, not a man you want to be in the ring with. Davey B fighting Killer Kel with everything. He's got the headbutt. Davey B already gaining the sympathy of the fans, it would seem, not letting his disability prevent him from chasing his dreams. Killer Kel just getting manhandled by Davey B in these opening measures. But Kel getting back into it. Killer Kel full mounting Davey B and just punching him. Now just slamming the head of Davey B into the mat. This is just hard to watch. Killer Kel, a trained world-class fighter, just crushing a man all for chasing his dreams. Oh my God, that is just not right. Killer Kel. This just is a shade of brutality that I did not expect to see. My God! James Jackson may need to get in there and tell Kel to give Davey B some space, because Killer Kel is giving him nothing. Killer Kel indeed just picking apart Davey B, stomping him repeatedly in all portions of the face, body, and legs. Davey B trying to fight back, but I mean, that was a lot of damage done. Davey B grabbing Kel though. Look at this! The fans on his side as he manages to stall out for a suplex. Killer Kel back to his feet, evades the attack and goes back in with those lethal legs. Kelly Oudre. This right here is what could be in the immediate future of Dylan Hyatt. Could Kel look to be a future world's champion? Tornado roundhouse from Oudre. And Davey B stays alive. Davey B managed to kick out. Kelly Oudre went in for the full mount, but Davey B is fighting back. Davey B is managing to fight back in the spear from Big Davey B. And the Batista bite locked in from Davey B. But immediately Kelly Oudre has the counter. Davey B stays on him though. Oudre shot into the corner. Davey B firing him with some elbows to the face of Kelly Oudre. Davey B inspiring so many, not allowing disabilities to write your destiny. Davey B taken down with a vicious dropkick by Killer Kel though. Those kickboxing instincts fighting him, but Davey B like a caged animal on the ground, refusing to say die, refusing to let Kelly Oudre bully him. He targets those lethal legs of Kel Liudre, more specifically the left one. Kel could be in trouble here if he keeps targeting that leg. Kick from Davey B is countered by Liudre. Big toss over into that knee strike. James Jackson ready to call it at any time if Davey B wants to submit. The caged animal, Davey B. This animal may be coming unleashed if Kel Liudre is not careful. Just repeated targeting of the leg from Kel Liudre. King Kong off the middle rope. Kel back up. Tornado roundhouse from Liudre. And that will seal it. Kel Liudre gets a win over Davey B. Maybe a foregone conclusion to some, but to Davey B, living his dream is the greatest honor of all. We move into the next match. Well, I get you flipping off the shit that I'm kicking. The Lone Ranger, co-ed, danger, deep in the dark with the art. And as we get into our main event here in Los Angeles, California, CC Chambers will make his first defense of the Dragon Warrior Championship. The revolution will be televised as Absolute Ricky Starks makes his way down the aisle. Ricky Starks last week had an incredible debut against James Darnell, showed some incredible resolve. And the move to look out for from Ricky is that deadly spear that he's got lined up. He can nail that. You are definitely in trouble if you are CC Chambers. Ricky Starks in one match flat showed enough potential for Axel Hyatt to greenlight this matchup for an opportunity for Starks to become the Dragon Warrior champion, to be the second man in history to etch his name on the side plate. Only one name etched on it so far, that being CC Chambers, the inaugural champion. Two weeks ago, defeated Johnny Beginnis 7-4. That Iron Man match showed a lot of resolve. Did CC Chambers. But anyone can win a championship. It takes a different breed of shark to defend one. Makes his way down the aisle, however, looking to do just that here tonight in Los Angeles, California. CC Chambers, the Triple C, definitely looking to keep that belt around his waist, has no intentions of losing it this soon in. But CC Chambers also cannot afford to let his guard down. Ricky Starks shown to be incredibly crafty. You have to know that craftiness is not a one-time deal when it comes to Absolute Ricky Starks. That's what it's all about, ultimately. Your right to have your name etched on the side plate of the Dragon Warrior Championship. Absolute Ricky Starks versus the Triple C, CC Chambers. Main event here tonight. CC immediately starting off with a springboard dropkick to Ricky Starks. And CC throws Ricky into the corner. Pretty Ricky already feeling the pain of CC Chambers. Big body slam out of the corner. And CC playing a little dirty with that choke on the ground to Ricky Starks. Went for the double stomp, but Starks got back to his feet. Starks grabbing Chambers now, looking for a power bomb. No, actually nails a Yamabama, that power bomb lung blower. Now pulling on the arm of CC Chambers is Ricky Starks. Just trying to deal some extra damage, but a sweep to the leg. Double stomp again evaded by Ricky Starks. Could the revolution start tonight? Or rather continue from what Ricky did last week against James Darnell. Went for the chop, nobody home. And CC Chambers with a rope-assisted springboard cutter. My God. Spiking Ricky Starks in one of the most brutal springboard cutters I've ever seen. My God, CC Chambers is showing a mean streak to him, saying that this championship will not be taken off of him so easily. CC only gets one though. Ricky Starks definitely gonna take a little more than that to put away. Went for the knee drop, took a little too long to measure up, and that is why CC counters Ricky though with the shots to the face. The winner of this match will go on to defend the championship against Wade Urena as the tornado kick is evaded by Ricky Starks. Wade has challenged the Dragon Warrior champion to a match at Dead Man's Hand, and it was written, so it will be done. Tornado kick by CC Chambers. Goes in for the cover, but only gets two. Does CC Chambers. Ricky desperately needs to get back into this one. And the spear is evaded by Chambers. Some incredible hops from CC. And a sleeper slam done in by Ricky, or by CC Chambers to Ricky Starks. And this could be the beginning of the end right here. The Swanton from CC. And now CC is looking for it. Could be looking for the end here. No, Ricky counters. Gotta give it to Ricky for knowing all the counters to CC's maneuvers. He's definitely studied the tape. Back and forth they go. Big Death Rider there by Chambers. CC grabbing Ricky Starks in that crossface. We saw him get a submission point over Johnny Beginnis in the Iron Man match with this crossface. But not quite able to put him away. Finally connects with that double stomp, does CC Chambers. Went for the kick, but Ricky not having any of it. Ricky Starks with a snapmare to CC Chambers off the ropes with that running pump kick to the face. Ricky Starks staying all over CC. Kick, and it could be time to play some Rochambeau for Ricky Starks to win the Dragon Warrior Championship. Not quite. Ricky thought he had him off the Rochambeau, but not going to get it done that easily. CC one hard man to put down, undefeated here in TNT, or in 1WW and on TNT, excuse me. And now Ricky Starks locking in that dump puller, moves out of the way. Ricky manages to maintain control momentarily, but moves out of the way again. Ricky grabbing CC. Oh my God, the disrespect, the Styles clash to CC Chambers. Two. Not quite. Ricky thought he could bust out one of the most devastating moves we've seen to get the win. The Anaconda Vice locked in on CC now. That arm trapped sleeper hold applied to Chambers, but not quite able to get the win with that either. CC though, desperately trying to get back to his feet, wants to deal some damage. Tornado kick to Pretty Ricky. Goes in for the cover. Two. Not quite as Starks pops that shoulder up. Ricky Starks stealing the Styles Kuka clash from CC. But nobody does it better than the original Triple C himself. He gets it done, deals the hand. One, two, three, and CC Chambers retains. And that means it will be CC versus Wade at Dead Man's Hand. An absolutely incredible matchup to main event this episode of One Warrior Wrestling USA. Congrats to CC for retaining. We will see you in the next episode. Thank you for watching.